Commissioners Court of Brazos County will meet in regular session on November 29th, 2022 at 10 a.m. in Commissioners Court Room, County Administration Building, 200 South Texas Avenue, Suite 106. Our first item on the agenda is the invocation pledge of allegiance of the U.S. Texas flag on the field. Father, I want to thank you for your love, your mercy. I want to thank you for all the blessings that we have by living in the country we live in. In spite of all the problems we have, Father, it's still the best country in the world. Father, I ask that you'd be with us this morning as we do county business, and that everything we do be for your glory. I ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
I pray your allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas. One state, under God, one and indivisible.
Yeah, in light of, we know Kenny Mallard was, I think he was here 12 years as a commissioner, and he passed away. His funeral's today at A&M United Methodist Church, 417 University Drive, College Station. I'd like to stay, have a moment of silence with, think about his family, his wife, and that family. Okay, I appreciate that. Thank y'all.
Thank you.
Say that the service is at 2 o'clock.
Yes, the service is at 2 o'clock today. Next is citizen input and or concern. And Roy, I think you signed up to come up today.
Roy Flores, 507 East 31st. Hope you all had a good Thanksgiving. A few weeks back, I came here and I learned quite a bit. For those who believe in smaller government and no new taxes, creating new bureaucracy and instituting taxes for that doesn't sound like the right direction. I learned about MPOs and how they are not able to do toll roads, and that by Texas law, you cannot put a toll road on an existing highway. Correct me if I'm wrong. But so thereby, when I looked at the 2050 map, it showed OSR and the new road being built about 1,000 yards away from it, you know, a little more than that. And it got me to wondering why you wouldn't just expand OSR and go forward. But that seems to bring into play the new bureaucracy of the RMA. And, of course, the appointment of the chairman by Austin. I also learned about special interest PACs and that the funding of advertisement by these PACs, some of which you can't even find who their donors are. Now, the media can't be blamed for this because with lower subscriptions and less viewers, the advertising money of tens to sometimes hundreds of thousands of dollars, you know, they're not going to bite the hand that feeds them. And but the taxpayer doesn't pay the salaries of the media, pays the elected officials' salaries and your health care and your retirement. And so taxpayers, when they come and they ask for answers, they'd like to be able to get it from their elected officials and not be told to go look it up themselves, because That's kind of like when you hire a mechanic or a doctor, you're paying them for the answers. Well, we're paying y'all for the answers because this is y'all's job. And we appreciate that job too. Several weeks ago, I brought facts from the internet, from the RMA, then I gave each and every one of you a copy that showed about what the Texas transportation code was about trailers. And I explained to you what the Austin appointed chairman was saying, which was in conflict with that. Now, I never heard from y'all or that y'all had investigated or even brought it up. But it is discouraging to find that people that have talked against the RMA are being used character assassination on them by saying they're putting out misleading information. Well, thank you very much. And I hope I hope each and every one of y'all have a wonderful Christmas.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Same to you.
Any other citizen input and/or concerns? Hearing none, we'll consider and take action on agenda items 3 through 13. Number 3 is approval of resolution 22-33, requested by the governor's office to update the bullet resistant shields grant application for Constable Precinct 3 that was approved in court September 30, 2022.
Move approval.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? None. Motion carries. Number 4 is approval of Texas County District Retirement System Plan Agreement for 2023.
Move approval.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Non-motion carries. Number 5 is request from Fleet Services for payment authorization to Ike's Small Engine for items used for small engines in the amount of $133.62. Purchase order was obtained and closed prior to payment due close to the fiscal year end.
Move approval.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Non-motion carries. Number 6 is approval of contract 23-075 PREA audit for Adult Detention Center with Rising Star Auditing Service, LLC.
Move approval.
Second.
Motion made. Seconded. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Non-motion carries. Number 7 is approval of contract CIP 23-568 City of Bryan runoff election with Texas Voting Services to be held December the 8th, 2022.
Second.
Motion made. Seconded. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? None. Motion carries. Number 8 is tax refund application for the following.
Move approval A through Y.
Second.
Motion made. Seconded. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? None. Motion carries. Number 9 is budget amendments. Budget amendments FY22/23. Budget amendments 8.01 through 8.02.
Move approval.
Second.
Motion made. Seconded. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? None. Motion carries. Number 10 is personnel change of status.
Move approval A.
Second.
Motion made. Seconded. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Non-motion carries. Number 11 is payment of claims. Claims to be paid by Brazos County, claim number 8119159 through claim number 8119221 and claim number 9006335 through claim number 9006363.
Move approval.
Second.
Motion made. Seconded. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? None. Motion carries. We're going to skip down to number 14 is an acknowledgement of the FY22-23 budget to actuals by fund as of November 20, 2022. And B is the acknowledgement of FY22-23 contingency budget to actuals by fund of as of November 20, 2022.
Move approval.
Second.
That was an acknowledgement.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
That's right.
I was almost ready to take it too.
You were going to pass that motion, okay.
Yeah, sorry.
That's all right.
Gotta pay attention.
15 is acknowledgement of the monthly report submitted in November of 2022. 16 is juvenile director's report on detention populations.
Good morning, Judge and Commissioners. We have 38 juveniles in detention, 33 males, 5 females, and we have 24 on electronic monitor. Thank you.
Thank you, Linda. 16, or 17 is juvenile, is sheriff's report on inmate population. Sheriff.
Good morning.
Good morning.
673 today. That's 575 men, 98 women. We have 67 on monitor.
Good.
Population's creeping up.
No, it shot up. We were at about 635 last week, but the only explanation I have is a home football game tends to increase business a little bit.
And I was thinking it was that the kitchen, you know, crew and Thanksgiving dinner.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sheriff. Number 18 is announcement of interest items and possible future agenda topics. And again, Kenny Mallard's funeral is today at 2:00 at United Methodist, or at the Aggie.
A&amp;M.
A&amp;M United Methodist on University Drive. Any other announcement? Number 19 is call for citizens' input and/or concerns. Hearing none, we will go back to number 12 and convene an executive session pursuant to the following. Texas Government Code 551.071 to consult with an attorney about pending and/or contemplated litigation and/or a settlement offer. And B, Texas Government Code 551.074A1 to deliberate the appointment, employment, evaluation, reassignment, duties, and discipline or dismissal of the chief public defender. And we need the Commissioners Court, Cheryl, Bruce.
Is this for A or B?
Well, we'll do A first.
Okay. I have Ms. Emerson here from the Ellsworth Law Firm.
Okay.
And then probably purchasing the doctor's office and potentially the juvenile director since concerns are real.
Okay.
Time.
And the time is 10:13. Y'all ready? Okay, we're coming out of executive session. It's 10:45, and I think there is action to be taken.
Judge and Commissioners, I'd like to move to retain the Allensworth Law Firm for advice and representation regarding construction issues with the Juvenile Justice Center.
Second.
Motion made and seconded to retain Allensworth.
Allensworth.
Allensworth for some potential advice and litigation potentially. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? None motion carries. And that's the only action, and next item is to adjourn. Thank you.
Thank you.